It was originally a piece for theatre that was commissioned by the Bush Theatre in West London, which is one of the most important theatres for new writing in Britain. And actually, I think because of the nature of British theatre and the particular role of new plays in Britain, one of the most important theatres for new writing in the world extension from that. And in the spring and summer of 2008, when the rainfall in London was unpredictably poor, quite a high level of rainfall, the theatre flooded. It's just a little room above a pub in Shepherd's Bush, and it was drenched by this torrential rain. And they had to take the lighting rig out, and they had to take the seats out. And there was a new artistic director at the time. It was a woman called Josie Rourke. And because she just started, rather than going dark, which would have felt like which means closing the theatre, which would have felt like a very defeatist attitude for somebody just starting off their tenure as artistic director, she decided to commission a whole series of short plays that could be produced in a theatre with no lighting and where the seats were just kind of like normal seats. So she emailed me. I was on holiday with my wife and my kids and my father-in-law in the west coast of France, actually, not the south of France. And I got an email from her asking me if I'd write a monologue that could be produced in natural light. And partly because I love the bush, and partly because I quite like the challenge of writing for specific circumstances, I got actually quite excited by the idea and decided that I'd have a go at it. And having agreed to do that, I was left in a position, and this was in the middle of August 2008, to decide what on earth I was going to write. And I knew that it was commissioned with a performance date, that it was going to be performed in November. So I had, you know, effectively 4 weeks to write something. And there was a whole load of different elements came together at once in the writing of the script. I was on holiday in France is one. I was on a holiday in France with my wife is another, and with my father-in-law, who, although he's not a kind of military figure, is somebody who's quite strange, and also somebody I've known for a long time. And like Alex and Seawall, I do love him. He's kind of strange but great. So I kind of almost wrote about the experiences of that holiday and all the different details of the holiday, like the little yogurts and the shampoo and the sunglasses and him reading a book on the history of China and the cove closer to his house than the main beach, are all just descriptions of my holiday, really. There's a whole load of elements that just come directly from what I was living through. And but that's not really enough to make drama out of a nice holiday in France. But I was swimming one day. I did go down to this cove with Martin, who's my father-in-law, and my two sons. And he went for a swim, came back, said the water's lovely. I noticed the cracks on the soles of his feet. I thought, gosh, you're a lot older than I normally think of you as being. He sat and read his book, which is The History of China, and I went for a swim. And I'd swim how Alex swims. I swim as far as I think I can. Then I think, right, I'm going to go back now. And then I go, no, I'll do 10 more strokes and then come back. And I was doing that, and I did. And I turned around. I could see the curve of the bay. And I could see all those things that Alex describes. I could see my kids playing behind him, and he wasn't really paying any attention to them. And I just thought, what if one of them fell?